Hi guys, welcome back. In this video, we will see the practical usage of a process group and how to communicate between process groups using input and output ports. Let's get started. In NiFi, one or more processors are connected and combined into a process group. We can add a process group by dragging and dropping the process group icon to the canvas. Once we add a process group, NiFi will prompt for a name. Here, I will name the process group as CSV to JSON converter. That's it. To add the required processors along with its connection to a process group, we can press the Shift key and click and drag around the processors. This will select all the processors and connections or any other components available as part of the selection area. If the flow is significantly big and extending outside the current canvas view, you can zoom out a little bit using the mouse wheel or the zoom out option available as part of the navigate menu and try again. Once all the required components are selected, we can click any of the components available in the selection and drag and drop inside the process group which we just created before some time. Please note, a blue border appears when we are above the process group. This will act as an indicator to drop correctly. Now that we have added the previously created flow inside the process group, we can go ahead and look inside the process group by double-clicking on the process group. Did you see that? All the processors and connections are now successfully added as part of the process group. To leave the process group we are currently in, we can right-click the canvas and select Leave Group. We can also use the breadcrumb below to navigate out of the process group. When we have a complex data flow, it's better to combine processors into logical process groups. This helps in better maintenance of the flows. Process group also helps us in flow reusability and provides an easy way to duplicate and modify a similar type of flow. To duplicate a process group, you can click the process group you want to duplicate and copy it using Command C or Control C and paste a duplicate of it using Command V or Control V. This way, not only the process group, all the components inside the process group will get duplicated along with its configurations. Next, let's see how we can communicate between two process groups using input and output port. Sometimes, we may create a process group which will do a specific set of work and produce an output. This output will be needed as an input for another process group. In this case, we have to transfer data from one process group to another. To do so, we can use the input and output port. But before adding any input and output port, I would like to split the current flow into two. To be more precise, I would want to move the put file processor along with the update attribute processor to a new process group. You may ask why. The most obvious reason is this way I can use the existing flow rather than creating a new flow. But this can be very well be a real world scenario where currently you are saving the converter JSON to a file system. Later you may want to save it to a database. So it's better to decouple both the CSV to JSON conversion and writing the JSON to a file system. Let me first go ahead and add a new process group. I will name this process group as Write JSON to File System. Next, we can remove the connection between the RepleaseText processor and the Update Attribute processor. Then we can select the two processes we would like to move and drag and drop inside the newly created process group. Since the new process group is still inside the old process group, it is not yet loosely coupled. To make it entirely loosely coupled, we will need to keep both the process group parallel to each other. To do so, we can right-click the new process group and select Move to the Parent Group. That's it. But we have one big problem now. The flow will not work because there is no connection between the replace text processor of the CSV to JSON process group to the update attribute processor of the write JSON to file system process group. This is where the input and output port will be used. Before fixing this issue, I would also like to highlight, though the name has the term port in it, doesn't mean we need to open any network port for each input and output port we are adding. In NiFi, all the input and output ports are accessible with the default port on which NiFi is running. In our case, it's 8080. We can refer the individual input and output port using its name. Here, the CSV to JSON process group has to send data or flow file to the write JSON to file system process group. So, first we need to add an output port in the CSV to JSON process group and connect the replace text processor to it. Next, we can add the input port inside the write JSON to file system process group and connect it with the update attribute processor. As you can see, adding an input or output port is no way different than adding any other components in NiFi. That's the reason I have not explicitly explained how to do the same. Going forward, I will keep it simple and will skip the basic explanation of adding any components and creating or realigning the connection between those components. This way, we have more time to concentrate on the actual implementation. Let's continue and finish our flow by connecting the two process groups by establishing a connection between them. Please be noted, each process group can have more than one input and output ports according to the use case. And we can only establish a connection between two process groups if they have the correct set of input and output port. For example, you can only connect a process group which has an output port with the process group which has an input port. If both the process group is having only input ports or only output ports, we cannot establish the connection. Here, we have only one input and output port, so we can click on the Add button to confirm the connection. If we have more than one input and output port, we can use the appropriate dropdowns to select the correct port for which we would like to establish the connection. Now we have fixed the flow, we can go ahead and start both the process groups by right-clicking the process group and click on Start. This way, all the processes inside the process group will get started. The same is applicable if you want to stop them all. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you got a fair understanding of the practical usage of process groups and input and output ports. Thank you. See you in the next video.